Hey guys, it's C-Drama Invasion here. Welcome back to my channel. And if you're new, this is a new series or installment on my channel where I plan to cover 3 to 4 popular actors or actresses in Chinese drama land and give you their latest news, updates, and things related to their life and obviously their upcoming dramas and what they're filming currently. So last time we covered Wang Yibo, Xu Kai, and Dylan Wang. Make sure to check the links below in the description box for that playlist or for that video link. And make sure to check out the rest of the links down below for videos such as top 10 recommendation lists and facts and profile videos where I cover their biography and lifestyle. Anyways, if you haven't subscribed yet, make sure you subscribe and make sure to give this video a big thumbs up so I know whether or not I should continue this series for good permanently on this channel. I'm just playing around right now and I'm not too sure, so hopefully it does well, and comment down below what your thoughts are on any of these news. Okay, today we are covering Hu Yitian, Zhao Luci, and Ding Yuxi's latest drama news. Let's start off with Hu Yitian. So he has been keeping busy with his upcoming dramas. At the beginning of September, Go Go Squid Season 2, the spin-off, is done wrapping up its filming, so it should be airing in 2021. And there are a lot of photos or posters that are out already. And this drama will be starring Hu Yitian, of course, and Li Yitong as the main leads. Even though it's not the same cast of characters, we do get cameo appearances of the wedding that was supposed to take place in Go Go Squid Season 1. So that's really good news, and I'm looking forward to that. The next drama that he started shooting in this month, October, is a drama called Hello, the Sharpshooter. This is a 2021 upcoming drama starring Fair Xing Fei, who you might know from Put Your Head on My Shoulder with Lin Yi. This drama, Hello the Sharpshooter, is a romance, sports, and youth drama. Hu Yitian's character is now a sharpshooting champion, and this story follows the female lead who is an intern who ends up meeting him. I think she's supposed to be an intern at some journalist company, and she's supposed to interview him. They actually have some history together in this drama. He used to have a one-sided crush on her, but a misunderstanding happens and causes him to be cold with her when they meet again in the future. Between shooting these dramas, he also has a lot of endorsements events that he goes to for many high-end products. And here are some photos from his latest photo shoots from Gucci and Elizabeth Arden. He also landed 85th place on TC Chandler's Top 100 Sexiest Men in the World list. Congratulations to him and his fans for participating in this year's event. If you don't know what this is, TC Chandler usually is known for their 100 Most Beautiful Faces list. They have a bunch of lists like that every year, and people get to nominate and vote idols, actors, or celebrities around the world. Next up, let's talk about Zhao Luci, and I've been addicted to her drama Dating in the Kitchen lately. I haven't finished it, but now that it's done subbing, I need to binge watch it. Zhao Luci has been on a roll lately. She has 3 to 4 upcoming dramas in 2021, and she has 3 dramas already out this year. She is just working her butt off, and I'm so proud of her. But hopefully she also gets the rest that she needs. Anyways, she recently released a poster for her upcoming drama, Please Feel at Ease, Mr. Ling. This drama stars Liu Te and Zhao Luci as the main leads. Liu Te made his first acting debut in the rom-com drama My Dear Lady in 2020. This drama is available on YouTube with English subtitles. And as always, I put all the listed drama names or movies or anything like that mentioned in the description box below, so you can search it up for yourself and look at it later. This is a rom-com drama about a girl who accidentally injures the wealthy heir. and then she has to take responsibility by nursing him back to health, and she decides to bring him to her house. I'm not sure if this is a cohabitation situation where they live together, but that's what it seems like based off of the pictures and based off of the summaries online. This doesn't have the most original plot, but since it's Zhao Lucy, I'm still sure this is going to be cute, just as all of her other dramas, and sweet. She is currently filming for a historical romance drama with Shu Kaicheng called A Female Student at the Imperial College. Shu Kaicheng's most recent drama he was in was in Dance of the Phoenix, which was a historical drama as well. This drama, however, it seems to be a reverse harem situation where Zhao Lucy's character is the only girl attending this academy. There has been a lot of attempts of this trope this year, but none of them really landed for me, and I hope that this one is good. Since it's in the very early stages, I don't think there's any character posters out yet, but when there is, I'll definitely try to update in upcoming videos, so make sure to subscribe. Let me know what your thoughts are about this pairing. Are you here for it? Are you not? Let me know in the comments down below. And let's move on to the last Chinese actor I chose for this episode, and this is Ding Yuxi. So let's cover everything he's been up to lately, starting with some words that he said for October Mid-Autumn Celebration. So on Hunan TV, he was invited to a special episode to celebrate the Mid-Autumn Festival Night. And he says, I quote, "I like you from past till now and into the future. As the full moon gathers us together, let's explicitly express love for one another." Ding Yuxi. Very recently, he was spotted at the ceremony, the booting ceremony for one of his upcoming dramas, and I believe they are already starting to film this drama. This drama is called Moonlight, and Moonlight is a romance business drama starring Esther Yu, who you might know from the hit show Youth With You, which was a survival idol competition show where she ranked really well. I think she ranked first or second place overall, and I really enjoyed that show. If you want to know more about Esther Yu or any one of these celebrities, then make sure to check out the celebrity facts and profile playlist link in the description box. Scroll around and you can find all of these actors and actresses, as well as many, many more. I've covered all of them extensively, from their background growing up to their dating news and rumors, as well as dramas. Anyways, Esther Yu, or Yu Shuxin, and Ryan Ding Yuxi is the main lead. Esther's character is a new university graduate entering the workforce. She joins a publishing company and meets Ding Yuxi's character, who is an author in real life. Despite not getting along with him in real life, these two have a long-term friendship online without realizing, and there seems to be a hidden identity type of situation. It sounds really interesting. And the last drama I've watched with this type of hidden identity meeting online trope is Love 020, which I definitely love. So hopefully this will be somewhat similar or just as good. So that is it for today's episode. These take forever to compile, but I already have the first three episodes written down, the script, and it's just ready to go. I just need to film and edit it. So if it does well, then I'll continue this for sure. I think it's a great way for me to update on my favorite celebrity news. I thought that this was a pretty original idea, since most of the other channels that are reporting in English usually talk about the general Chinese drama news, like all upcoming dramas this week or the top 10s of the week or whatever. But I decided to kind of zoom in and talk about a couple, like three or four actors or actresses and their recent news in the past 1 or 2 weeks. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, make sure to turn on that notification bell to all so you don't miss out on any of my future videos. Give this video a big thumbs up. It really, really does help me. And comment something down below that also helps me with engagement as well. Thank you so much for watching and supporting my channel. Happy drama watching. Stay safe, stay happy, and I'll see you next time. Bye.